नमस्ते, खुश रहो बेटिया। आई जेबियन वर्षा सिंह फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस्ड अबाउट शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट टाइम। ओके, सो इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट टाइम विदाउट अराइवल टाइम, बिकॉज दे वी हैड अज्यूम्ड दैट all the process reached at the same time, which is zero. But in this problem I have given arrival time for each process. Okay, so in this problem we have four process, right? And every process has different arrival time, and here is its burst time. Okay, so how to solve this problem? We have to keep two things in our mind. Whenever we have to solve the shortest job first time, we have to keep on our mind the criteria of shortest job first is your burst mode. That means we have to give attention on burst time. Burst time means working time. How much time required for each process in CPU? Okay, and what is the mode of this shortest job first? That is non-preemptive. Non-preemptive means whenever process allocate a CPU, then it complete its work. It does not release the CPU unless it need input output devices. Okay, we have discussed all in theory session, right? So see how to solve this problem. First of all, we have to draw Gantt chart. That is called Gantt chart, right? Okay, I have taken different kind of a problem, because in previous problem we have solved when process is reached at zero time. Okay, but here your first process is reached at one time. That means your CPU is idle from 0 to 1, so we have to give the idle sign of your CPU. Suppose the P1 reached at 8, then your CPU will goes to the 0 to 8 second. Suppose every process have different arrival time. Suppose P1 has 8 and P2 has 9, P3 is 14 and P4 is 20. In that case, your idle time of CPU is 0 to 8. But here, P1 is reached at 1. So, only 1 second is your idle time of your CPU. Right? Okay. So, at P1 time, two process enter in your ready queue. See, P1 and P3. But we have to compare their burst time. Which process has less burst time? So P3 process has less burst time compared to P1. It requires only for 2 seconds and P1 requires 3 seconds. So first P3 got the allocation of CPU and then it completed their work at 3 seconds, and then after that P1 get the allocation of CPU and then it execute their work at 3 for 3 seconds. okay, and then it complete their work at 6 seconds. But another process has also reached, which is P2, because it reached at P2 seconds. But we have to ignore, because here is no problem what process is coming, because when one process is in running state, it can't preempt. Okay, however it is lesser burst time or greater, no matter. Okay, so after that P2 executed for 4 seconds, and at 4 seconds P4 is also in ready queue, and then it also executed and completed their work at 14 seconds. Okay, so if we have to find the completion time of each process, then we have to calculate the completion time. P1 is completed at 6, so we have to give the 6. When P2 is completed at 10 seconds, okay, and P3 is completed at 3, so 3, and P4 is completed at 14, so 14 is given. Okay, after that we have to keep two formulas in our mind, how to calculate turnaround time and how to calculate waiting time. So turnaround time is calculated by the difference between completion time minus arrival time, and waiting time is equal to turnaround time minus burst time. So see how I have calculated. From completion time minus arrival time, 6 minus 1 is 5, 10 minus 2 is 8, and 3 minus 1 is 2, and 14 minus 4 is 10. So and waiting time is calculated turnaround time minus burst time. So 5 minus 3 is 2, and 8 is, minus 4 is 4, and 2 minus 2 is 0, and 10 minus 4 is 6. Okay, and now we have to calculate the average turnaround time and average waiting time. So this is the solution of this problem. I hope you will try to understand, and I hope also you have to try one or more questions on your notebook related to this topic. Okay, so that's all in this session. Thank you. This digital version 2.0 is provided by Jyoti Vidyapith Women's University. Thank you.